Today I'm going to be showing you how to make a 360 degree video using 3ds Max. Now, I've already made a few of these, and what it is it allows you to create a full 360 degree video, which you can pan around in a browser. You can also use Google Chrome, or you can just use your phone with a single display. Now, there are some cameras you can purchase for this, however, you can also do it in 3ds Max, and I'm going to show you that today. There are some prerequisites. First of all, you do need 3ds Max. You also need Vray to render a 360 degree video. And you also need Python or a 360 metadata plugin. And I'm going to have as many links below as I can, including a free trial of 3ds Max. So to begin, we're going to create a quick scene. Nothing special, just a couple of objects and a plane. Okay, now that we have a quick scene created, the most important thing here is actually going to be the camera. So we're actually going to create a free camera. Now we do have to do some rotation on this. And just move it so it focuses on an object. Okay, so that's got to be brought up a little bit. Okay, so now that we have our camera set up, let's do a real quick test render, and that's what you see in the scene. So, we need to tell the camera to grab everything around it. So, to do that, we're going to go into the render setup, scroll down, under Assign Renderer, select Vray. And now that Vray is selected, we're going to go into the Vray options. Under type, it's under camera. We're going to change the default to spherical because we want it to see everything in a sphere. And we're going to override the field of view and change it from 45 degrees to 360 degrees. And let's go ahead and render one frame of that just to see what it looks like. Okay, as you can see, it is actually capturing the entire scene around it. Now, since it's going to be a 360 degree view, we need a very high height and width for the camera. So under output size, we're going to go to HDTV, and we're going to select the 1920 by 1080. Now, we're only going to render about 50 frames of this, and the reason I'm doing this is so it cuts down on render time, and the plugin I use to inject the metadata for the 360 degree video needs to be MPEG-4. So what we're going to do is we're going to render this scene out in compressed AVI, upload it to YouTube, splice it together a couple times to make it a longer video, download it, and then use the plugin. And I'll show you guys all that in a minute, but we're going to go ahead and save the file. We're going to go AVI, and I'll just call this Test 360. I'm going to override my old one. MPEG compression is fine, and hit the render button. And I will be back when that is done rendering. Okay, everybody, I'm back, and it rendered, and it's only about 1 second. And I've already gone ahead and uploaded it to YouTube. So we're just going to click on the video. And we're actually going to go to Enhancements and try the YouTube Video Editor. Now the reason we're going to do this is we're going to make that video longer. And you can just click and drag the video multiple times to make it as long as you want, because it's just going to be the same scene on loop. Now obviously if you want to just do one long render, like if you're doing a roller coaster simulator or a diorama of anything, you can. So I've gone ahead and made it a 30-second video. So when you're using the Google Cardboard or the browser or just your phone, you'll be able to pan around in this video for up to 30 seconds. So we're just going to rename it. Ready to convert to MPEG-4. I'm just naming it that so I know exactly which video it is. And we're going to go ahead and create the video. And that may take a little bit of time, so we will continue once this is ready to download. Okay, so that took a lot less time than I expected, so we're going to go to Video Manager, go to the 30-second 360 video we created, and we're just going to hit the down arrow here, and we're going to download the MPEG-4. Now that that's downloaded, we are going to put that in the same folder as our 360 video meta tool plugin. And we can get rid of the 1 second test at this point. Okay, so now that we have the plugin open, we're going to find the file we're going to open. We're going to check spherical, and we're going to save as. Now, as you can tell, it has injected at the end of it. I'm just going to call it demo injected. Save it. And now this video actually has the data needed to be able to pan using the Google Cardboard or the browser or just your phone. So from there, we are going to re-upload it. Hopefully that'll process fairly quickly. Now it hasn't detected the metadata yet. That can take anywhere from a half an hour to an hour, unfortunately, to where it will detect that it's a 360 degree video. Okay, so YouTube has finished detecting that it is a 360 degree video. Just to show you real quick, we have the 1 to 2 second render we did, followed by the 30 second video we created with that 1 to 2 second video by adding it a couple of times. And then this was downloaded and converted into an injected 360 video. So just to show you what we ended up with, I can now pan this entire scene in 360 degrees, and as you can see, those are the objects we created. And this is also going to be compatible with the Google Cardboard. Now if you want, obviously you can move around in the scene. As I had mentioned, a lot of people are doing the roller coaster VR, and the 360 video is perfect for this, because you are actually moving the user rather than them moving themselves. so you really just need to render the view. And that's it. If you guys have any questions, comments, or concerns on how this was done, feel free to post them below. I'll be more than happy to answer them. I'm going to put as many links down below as possible. The one I will definitely provide is the tool that I used to inject the data needed to create this. And have a great one.